Now, at that time, Berkeley was in the midst of a little political upheaval. A lot of things were going on between there and the University of California and the student riots. And because the Berkeley Community Theater was such a small space, there were a lot of people trying to get in. So one of the things we did with the truck that was parked out in back of the theater was, I said, let's just open the back doors. And we had maybe 300 or 400 people standing outside listening to the monitors in the truck, which sort of precluded having a little bit more of a riot that might have happened.
Hendrix in the West has so much great music on it, but if all that existed was the Red House from that album, that would almost be enough. A lot of people I know think it's the best performance, and it's completely exquisite.
We call this one a blues, and we call this one Red House. We're going to do that for a second. There's a Red House over yonder, baby. It's where my baby stays.
Our touring experience was very limited compared to what we saw just even 10 years after Jimmy's death. All of the musical equipment, all the PA equipment, the band gear, a little bit of wardrobe, and a few lights all fit in one 19-foot U-Haul truck. So considering the difference between what they tour with today and what we had then, it was quite significant. But the idea still worked because it was the quality of the show. His musical ability just outshone any of the other physical limitations that we might have had as far as putting on the show. Jimmy's live performance desires and wishes was basically that he could be playing for all these people in his living room. That was what he intended to make this concert feel like. For almost the entire time that we did his sound, there was only 8 microphones used. There was no lights. We had, you know, 3 follow spots, and the 3 spots stayed on the 3 band members. That was the extent of the outside production. The rest of it was all between the 3 great musicians that performed.
One thing that Jimmy and I agreed on is at that time, I mean, there was no way of trying to recreate on stage what you could do in the studio. I mean, these days, yeah, I mean, you can, you can, if you so desire, you can push a pedal and, you know, away it goes. That was the beauty for me of playing with Jimmy, is the stage experience, good, bad, or indifferent, was different from, I mean, you know, a live thing was a live thing.